As we wind down from the excitement of qualifying, here's a look at your top three. Aitken, Latifi, and Guan Yu Zhou. The grid is set then, so that just leaves the race itself. Join us tomorrow where we'll be live with all the action, and until then, goodbye. And here in Russia, today's race is about to start. We're at the Sochi Autodrome, and the drivers on the grid are almost ready to begin. Join us as we enjoy today's Formula 2 event. Let's examine the Sochi Autodrome then. Two DRS zones around this 3.6-mile circuit, one on the long run towards Turn 2, and another leading into Turn 13. 18 corners in total, and plenty of opportunities for the drivers to push their cars to the limit. With so much time spent at full throttle, engine failures are a risk that teams must be prepared for. With me at Sochi for the Russian event is Davide Valsecchi. This is a long and complex circuit. Davide, what are your thoughts heading into it?
Hi, Alex. Yeah, you're right. This is still a very exciting circuit. Lot of winding turns and high-speed straights. The racing here should be extremely close from start to finish. I think we'll see a great race today, and I can't wait to get underway.
We're almost ready to go then, and this is what the starting grid looks like for today's race. Jack Aitken lines up on pole position, edging out Nicholas Latifi, who will start from P2. Looking down the rest of the grid, we have Joe, Correa, Dorian Boccalacci, and Giotto. De Vries, Mazepin, Hubert, Nobuharu Matsushita, Alesi, Delatraz, Sergio Sete Camara, and Ilott, Schumacher, Calderon, King, and Sean Gelael. Raghunathan and Ralph Boschong completes the grid. And with preparations almost complete, let's head down to the track. Thank you.
it up. Nice work. That brings you up a place. approaching the pit window, you'll be on the mediums. Issues with tire wear for now. Keep taking care of them. Is in the pits. Nick in the pits. Box, box. We're coming in this lap. We'll be right back. Exit now. You'll be racing as you leave the pits. Exit. Exit now. Look after these tyres now. We want to finish the race on this compound. There's an incident in the next part of the track. No overtaking through the yellow flags. races ahead of you. Our gap to the car in front is 2.2 seconds. They're on fresh mediums. Their tyres are 3 laps old. The time last lap was a 1 minute 49.7. You're falling back by 1/10 a lap. Move. top 10. Pulling out a second a lap on the car behind. Someone's come off ahead of you. There's a yellow flag ahead. We'll be right back. good. Good job. Nice overtake. Teammate by 2.1 seconds. This is your final lap, final lap of the race. That's the end of the race. We'll see you in Parc Fermé.
Brilliant stuff from Campos today. What a superb victory. And Davide Valsecchi, give me your thoughts. How did they accomplish this result?
This race, this week, was about one thing and one thing only. Consistency. Anyone can be quick for just one lap, but there's a difference between that and being quick every lap, over and over and over, when your opponents make mistakes. But then not make mistakes on your own, you can just push and push.
I can see them on their way out to the podium now. Campos have come a really long way in this sport. What a special race this was to see them earn the top spot. After this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the driver's table. Now then, Davide Valsecchi, who would you say was your driver of the day?
I think it's got to be Sean Gelael. It's not always spectacular, but he quietly gets the job done, and that's the case today.
And now a look at the team standings. It was a tough race for our championship leaders, who lose ground at the top of the table. Meanwhile, Arden's strong weekend allows them to continue their march up the table. Goodbye for now then. But we really are just getting started. Make sure you join us again for Lights Out tomorrow.